So that is what it is all about, recognizing one's dignity. What is equality in Indian democracy? First, Indian constitution recognizes every person as equal. This means that every individual in the country, including male, female, whatever, from all caste, religion, tribe, educational, economic backgrounds, are recognized as equal. No matter from where you come, educational and economic backgrounds are recognized as equal, including male, female. I was teaching class 5 in the earlier class today. Girls are not allowed to be educated. Raja Ram Mohan stopped that child marriage and Sati. 1829 it was abolished, 1987 it happened again, Rup Kanwar was killed, 2002 another 65 year old woman was burnt. Sati. This is equal. What is equality? Where is our dignity going? A girl cannot study. Just imagine that situation. We are out of that situation. Every person is equal before the law. No person can be discriminated against on the basis of religion, race, caste, place of birth, or whether that person is female or male. Every person has the access to all public places. Untouchability has been abolished. Harijan has been stopped. Harijan is a very good word which Gandhiji said. Son of God, son of Harijan, Harijan, holy person. Now what are the steps taken to implement equality in this democracy? Two ways in which government has tried to implement, that is guaranteed in the constitution. First through laws, second through government programs or schemes. I told you about the midday meal. In many democratic countries also, equality continues to be the main issue around which communities are still struggling. Just take an example of United States of America. The African Americans whose ancestors were slaves who were brought over from Africa continue to describe their lives today as largely unequal. They were treated extremely unequally in the US and denied equality through the law. You know that person who died, he was shot dead by the police. That police put his leg on his neck and the person died 2-3 months ago. He was a black American. He was a football player. Civil Rights Act 1964 prohibited discrimination on the basis of race, religion, or national origin. I'm talking about America. It also stated that all schools should be open to African American children and they would no longer have to attend separate schools specially set up for them. In the civil rights in 1964, America did this. So why not we? How do you recognize your dignity? You have understood by now that the caste we are born into, the religion we practice, the class background we come from, whether we are male or female, these are often the things that determine, you know, why some people are treated unequally. Om Prakash Valmiki and the Ansaris, I told you that story, were being treated unequally on the basis of the different caste and religion. The Ansaris never got a house to rent and Om Prakash Valmiki had to sweep his school every day. When people are treated unequally, that dignity is violated. Both for that Om Prakash Valmiki, I had told you, and the Ansaris was violated because of the way in which they were treated. Have you seen me drinking water? I am giving you an example with my cell phone. Have you seen me drinking water in school? You children get so tensed when I ask for water. When I ask, give me your bottle, let me drink some water, I open it and I drink it. What will happen? I don't care. It's water. You are drinking. Why can't I drink it? And why can't I drink it from your bottle? Am I special? First, I am a human being. After that, I am Indian. After that, I am an adult. After that, I am a responsible, disciplined person. After that, I did my studies. After that, I became a sharer. I am still not a teacher. I cannot go to that post because I am also still learning. I learn and I share. I cannot go to that post because I am a teacher. Oh, go bring me water. Go bring me a glass of water and a clean glass, wash it. Oh, you are title. What is your title? Valmiki. No. Don't come to my class. That's bad. I say, give me your bottle. I have favorite places, you know. I know students where they are going to have the bottle is kept. After my lunch time, I go and pick up the bottle from them direct. I don't ask anybody. That authority I have. I don't have to ask anybody. I just take that bottle and I drink. Sometimes I ask for water. I just show like that water. Oh, so many bottles come. First, no one used to give me bottles. They used to feel scared when I was new last year. Now I have to just do. By the time I do this, the bottles are ready. You know, I feel so happy. It's so great. You know, that integrity, that movement together, knowing each other, we are breaking our those social cultures. We are one, we are together. That is equality. There are glasses kept in the school. We wash the glass and drink water. Correct? What's the problem? I also drink water from that. So many people drink water from that. You are washing your hand in the tap. Why can't I wash my hand in the tap? I also wash it. Yes, sometimes you guys don't use the dustbin. I use the dustbin. You have that habit of throwing it. But you are learning. You have planted a tree for me. That tree must be there. It must have grown big now. It was a tulsi plant, right? Class 6, you had gifted me on Teacher's Day, if I am not mistaken. And it was planted and it's still there. You forgot to water it in the summer last year. I watered it. So these are the things which bring us together, right? Now, by treating that boy, making him sweep the school because of his caste, the teachers and his school friends also hurt his dignity badly and made him feel as he was less than equal to all other students in the school. But he was a child. What could he do about it? He was in that bad situation. It was his father, see, parents, it was his father who saw his son sweep, felt angry about this inequality, treatment, and confronted the teachers. The Ansaris didn't get a house to stay because people were trying to defuse them of their dignity. They were getting hurt because people refused to lease them their flats. Imagine the property dealer is telling them, change your name and title. So I am going to change my dignity to get a flat. I have to change my name, I have to change my religion. Where is India going? They do not deserve to be treated like that. They deserve the same respect and dignity as anyone else. So many things happen every day like this. I have a few family friends, rather I can say, I know them. They call themselves something great. That's why I don't mix with them anymore. I've stopped. I've cut off my friendship. Always saying that caste, this caste, I'll not sit there. I will not go to that restaurant. that is Muslim, that is Hindu, that is this, that is that, you know, all that type of nonsense. First, we are all human beings. Try to be human beings. Is the pandemic or the COVID-19 saying, oh, this is that ability, okay, at this caste I will not touch, I will go to that caste. It's hitting everybody. Then you are going to the hospital. Or you are going in this quarantine. You have got separate beds. Achha, beds for Hindus, beds for Muslims, bed for Christians, this zone, that zone, separate doctors. It's not done that way. So anyways, we'll come back. I'll come back again and talk to you about this. It's a very long issue. You know, there are things happening. We have to come to know. Parents, that's why I tell you every day, respect your parents. Learn from them. They are the ones who is your pillars of democracy. Four pillars are there. You have got two pillars at home, your mother and father. The main two pillars for your democracy and dignity. They give you your dignity. If anything happens for you, your friend will not fight. Your dad and mom will go and fight. That's why you must talk to them every day. Inform them every day what you are doing. Never say lies. Yes, lies we do say in life. But if we say a lie and it helps someone else, okay, that's fine. But generally, you should not say lies. Sisters help brothers. Brothers help sisters. Brothers help cousins. We help friends. Okay, those lies are acceptable. But generally, we should not say big type of lies which is going to hurt people. So it's always good to talk to your parents. Tell them what's happening in your life. They are the best guiders. They will guide you through. I will share, they will guide. So we are part of the pillars. This is how life will get disciplined and you will be in this democracy. The future you are, you will change the whole country. If Raja Ram Mohan can do that, Gandhiji did it, why can't you? You are also a human being, common man. We are all common in this world. Even Dhirubhai Ambani, the Ambani's fathers, grandfathers or fathers, they were all workers. They sell cloth from this place to that place, they used to go sell cloth. Today they are one of the richest people. How did they struggle? Disciplined life, good people. They don't make anyone small or big. Okay? So see you in the next class. Do your homework and make sure I'm going to put up some notes and question answers on the website. You just check it. Keep on checking the website because you will be there every day on the website and see the download section. Take care of yourselves. Be good. Stay safe. Stay happy. And respect your parents. Listen to them and tell them everything what's happening in life. You'll see it's going to be a change. God bless. Take care and see you soon. Bye-bye.